a great guy, great team. He wouldn't be here in front of me if he wasn't good. So I can't wait. This kind of fight intrigues me. You know, he has a lot of line. I have a lot of line, and I can't wait to go out there and do my thing.
A lot of people think this might be the start of a rivalry. Do you feel that way too?
About to find out.
We've seen you do a lot of these other workouts. Sometimes you get a little harder and a little longer. Is there a reason maybe today was a little more low energy?
I feel great. You know, I felt the energy from the crowd and stuff. You know, it was crazy. I was feeding off of them, and it was super crazy. We were just hitting mitts, you know. It's a show. I got to talk to Brad, you know, talk to some of the fans. Some of the fans they're crazy here. You know, they love me out here. Like I said, this is like it's the night out of Hawaii, so it's perfect.
Good to see you at that Mayo Worlds last night, that you won Fighter of the Year. Congrats. Can you maybe just, you know, speak to that, what it means to you?
Yeah, you know, it means a lot. It means a lot to me. And the main thing I wanted to do in my speech, you know, we was training last night, I'm sorry. But it means a lot to win the Fighter of the Year. You know, all the guys, all the past guys that won before me is great dudes. And the number one thing I wanted to get out and say was I wanted to thank my team. A lot of people think so we go in there, it's an individual sport, this is a team sport. I like to thank my coaches, Ryan Azores, Ivan Flores, Darren Yap, you know, Sucker Punch Entertainment, my management, and that's what it is about. You guys only see, if you guys put it in perspective, I fight maybe two times a year. You guys see me maybe 50 minutes out of the year. These guys see me so much, we put so much hours behind the scenes that it's unbelievable. I talk about how I have to give up family time and stuff. These guys gotta give family time. The real MVPs, my coaches and all my teammates. So I love you guys, and thank you guys for all the support.
You got that award and Brian got Breakthrough Fighter of the Year. Does that just elevate this fight even more, the fact that you guys are kind of on that level right now?
Hey, it should be huge, you know? This guy's always want to sit behind me.
Actually using that Tyler Minton against this fight, a couple fights now, how is that being
It's been great. It's been quite good. You look good. You know what I mean? I feel good. I feel great. And we can get there. You know, Tyler's a man. The only downside is having him live with me for 4 weeks. Like, it's kind of irritating. I'm just joking right now. I love that dude to death, man. He's like a brother. He takes a lot of my family members, bring him in, so that's what Hawaii people do, you know, bring him on. So Ohana leads family and we're my family.
Was there any fear or concern that it could affect this weight cut from turning around and doing it again?
Not at all, man. It is what it is. Things happen, stuff happens. Who is right there to make it? You know, who's right there to go? Who's ready to go? You know, doctors came in and they stopped him.
You think you could have made it if they hadn't stopped
him? Oh, for sure.
Yeah, so what's the state of your thing? This week with you, Rachel, Brad, just over the last couple of weeks, in Lima,
we got Ray Bada Cooper fighting on the 5th. It's going to be huge. And we got a couple guys fighting. We got a couple guys fighting on the Condemned Show next week on Tuesday. So it's going to be a big one. It's going to be a big one. I think the MMA, the Hawaii MMA wave is very strong right now. And a bunch of us are riding it. And I think so. We're going to make a smash in the MMA world this week. Brad took my shine for a little bit over there. He's over there taking my shine. I thought it was my time. Brad beat it, you know. But all jokes aside, that's what I said. If you can't get a UFC boy, it's the next best thing. And it's showing. Look at this crowd. The crowd is amazing. The crowd is crazy. Like I said, a bunch of cheers, a bunch of shockers, the Hawaiian flags everywhere. You know, they call this Night Island for a reason. It's supposed to unite the Night Island.
Is that Drake coming on
Saturday? Drake is in Toronto.
Max, is there any chance this is your last fight at 145, or do you feel like there's more to do here?
We'll see what happens, you know, The whole 55 talk is who, you know, who, it's a logjam up there right now. If you think about 55 is not clear cut, 45 was stuck in that log jam. We came and we unjammed it, you know? And to go back up to 55 and jam that back up, I don't know. You know, we see what happened. We see what the UFC wanted. We gotta sit down with the UFC. Of course, we gotta sit down with the doctors. Medically, we see what happened after this fight. And that's just it. It depends on who, you know, who we want me to fight. And of course, at 45, who's next at 45? So we see what happens. You know, there's a lot of questions, but only one question matters. And is this been blessed ever? So Saturday night, we'll find out.
I think we see on the outside. I know you're really anxious. You made the 7 months between fights longer and sooner. How are you going to kind of unleash this pent-up pressure that
you have? You know what? They say 4th of July was today. 4th of July, the fireworks is going to happen Saturday night. Man. It's going to be crazy. I get to be alongside history on this. History makes me win with my man DC Gang Gang. So I can't wait.
Nice, guys.